Greetings, Guardians. My name is Bife here. First of all, apologies if this audio sounds a little bit different from usual. I've moved, and as a result, the audio setup needs to be rebuilt a little bit and things have changed. So if things sound a little different or if things are a little echoey, let me know down below in the comments so that I know what to fix and how we might want to fix it. In the meantime, though, hi, this is kind of a testing video. There are more important things to talk about, though. Namely, we need to talk about what just happened in the epilogue for the season of the Splicer. And in order to understand a whole bunch of what's been going on, let's go ahead and explain the context behind it. There are several moving parts to all of this, first of which are the factions. The factions have been planning a coup this season. That has been revealed and is rather obvious through the lore, and it seems as though this was supposed to be the first act of it, where Lakshmi 2 try to open a portal into space in order to send all the Fallen there. This was one of those moments at which Lakshmi was using the device, by all seeming means. It was one of those moments at which Osiris had supposedly instructed her on how to use it in order to open said portal. It's also one of these moments at which she was doing this partly based on her vision, a vision that would see her, if everything went according to her plan, as the new leader of the city. But instead, she opened the portal and a Vex incursion, fueled as well by lots of Taken, was able to take over in the Botza district down where the Elixni Quarter is located. This, of course, was not only her doing. This was a coup that was backed by members of New Monarchy and also Dead Orbit. Although Dead Orbit was late to the schemes, Hideo seems as though he was very much wrapped up in the whole thing from the very beginning. Of course, this is something that would never have happened if it wasn't for Lakshmi's need to become, well, more politically powerful. This, of course, was partly fueled, supposedly, because of the presence of the Elixni. The Elixni that have been growing alongside us in the Botza district all season. The Elixni that have had a pretty tough time of integrating. But the Elixni were now the ones under threat. And all of this would lead us to what happened here and now. This would all start when we were summoned to the helm, where the servitor was allowing us to listen to an emergency broadcast. A broadcast that would send us to listen to Lakshmi's radio communication. This would be the moment at which she would attempt her masterstroke, a moment at which she would try to overthrow the Fallen, overthrow the Vanguard, and then take the city for herself. But something was not right, and ultimately her fate seems to have been a grisly one.
People of the last city, we have endured many great tragedies thanks to our strength and a steadfast commitment to humanity. The Traveler chose us. It abandoned the Fallen because they are unfit, unworthy of the light. They would take it from us if they could. The Vanguard have lost their way. They embrace the darkness. Welcome Aramis's followers into our midst with open arms. Force us to celebrate our lost heroes alongside those who murdered them. Yes, the endless night is over. But now, Mithrax and his house will use this opportunity to do what the Fallen have always done. Covet. Cheat. Steal. Kill. I have seen the future with my own eyes. And it has not changed. Doom still builds on our horizon like a terrible storm. But there is hope. Right now, loyalists to the future war cause and New Monarchy have rounded up the Fallen in our city with the aid of Osiris. I have learned how to safely command the power of the Vex. I will use it to do what the Vanguard will not. I will tear open a rift, banish the Fallen to the depths of space from where they came. We alone will save humanity. I have seen the darkest of futures. And with this act, I will.
No! No!
Ah! Following this, it was clear that we were going to have to defend the Elixni Quarter. As best we know, Vex have never infiltrated Earth. This is one of those moments at which the lore is a little divided. Some sources state that the Vex will conquer planet by planet, and others state that there are Vex burrowed into every world waiting to be activated, and the case for Earth is not clear. But this is the first time that the Vex have ever been on Earth as far as we know, and certainly is the first time they've been inside the city. In fact, this is one of the most serious incursions into the city since the Red War, and certainly is one of the most terrifying moments for any who were there to witness it. This is going to be an event that rightly ranks alongside the fall of the city at the start of the Red War, as well as events like Twilight Gap, where the city was besieged. And now, we would need to stand as its defenders. You and other Guardians would rally to the cause of Mithrax, and Saint 14 would also heed the call. His words and interactions with Mithrax, as well as everything that happened during the assault on the city and the attempt to shut down the Vex portal, are as follows.
The Guardian has broken their portal! Keep behind us! We will not let them harm you! Stand, friend! You will not fall today!
Now, inevitably, there are a lot of details that we need to go over, and there'll be more videos on that. Don't worry, I'm going to talk about the Harpy as time goes on, because, yeah, that's definitely something we want to talk about. But I think the other thing worth noting here is Osiris. Osiris was supposedly lost by Saint, and Osiris also supposedly was in this position of sitting there and, well, helping Lakshmi to open the portal. There's been a lot of words about how Osiris has been rather suspect and acting rather strange over these last few weeks of the season, and it certainly is something that is echoed and mirrored here. This is also one of those moments at which we need to remember that a certain hive god has been walking amongst the city and was in the guise of someone all along. This is one of those moments at which it might seem like we have found who Savathun was under the guise of. What Osiris's true fate is then, assuming that we are correct, and assuming that Savathun has indeed taken over Osiris in some manner, is unknown. Maybe it's simply the case that Osiris is being puppeted by the Witch Queen. Maybe it is the case that he is entirely consumed and now he is merely a disguise. It's not clear. But what does seem clear is that Osiris is now missing, and that he is going to be a key part of the story of Savathun going forward, which I imagine is going to lead us into the next season. Furthermore than this, I think it's worth looking into one more point to be made here, which is quite simply the way that this shapes the relations between the Elixni and humanity going forward. Humanity and the Elixni have always been at odds in one way or another, and great works have been made this season in order to try and bridge the gap. But there's an even greater issue that was going to be raised, which was always that there would be elements of humanity that would not have any good faith reason to believe the Elixni had truly changed. They needed someone to vouch for the Elixni. And now, there is no greater spokesman for the Elixni than Saint 14, the one who previously had defended the city most famously from them. He is now their greatest advocate. And it is one of those moments where this moment will go a long way towards healing the rift between humanity and the Lakshmi. Now, make no mistake, it certainly isn't going to be the case that this rift is completely healed. There are going to be shades of trouble going forward constantly, and I imagine that we haven't heard the last time that a human in the city gives a dirty look to an Lakshmi traveler. But I do think that now there are more chances for people to sit there and see the Lakshmi as they truly are. Just people. People trying to live and people trying to survive. People who were forsaken by the Traveler. Certainly is something that we need to remember is that the Lakshmi at heart are just survivors and that they are not truly evil. Maybe there are some who are selfish and use situations to their advantage. Maybe there are even criminal elements. And yes, there are some that could genuinely be described through the lens of evil. But as a species, it is wrong to damn them because of the actions of some. All of this leads us to one final note. We don't know where the story is going to go next, but it does appear that something dark is happening. Savathun, if she was under the guise of Osiris, was looking in the city and looked up to the Traveler. I have suspicions that she has some dark plan with us in mind, and if it is the case that she is looking to attack us in some way, she now has the ability to sit within the city, bide her time, and wait for the perfect moment to strike. We have no idea where she is, we have no idea where she will go, and we have no idea what her plan next will be. But I am almost certain that it is going to be calamitous. If the Endless Night was nothing but a taster, was nothing but a test, then I think we can guarantee that something far greater is on the horizon. Additionally, there are a few extra bits of dialogue that I want to round out with. Something from Saint 14, which touches on our relations with the Lakshmi, and something from Ikora Ray. Two somethings, actually, because you can get some dialogue from the Helm as well as from her later. This is one of these moments at which I feel as though most people would have missed the last one, so I'll go ahead and play these for you before we end.
Guardian, the city remains. We have wrestled another day from those who would take it, but not without loss, and not alone. Elixni, Mithras, they stood with us, brothers and sisters in battle. This is a bond that cannot break. Their loss will be buried beside our own. Ikora was wise to look to our future instead of the past. We must remember that it is the Lakshmi who came to us, laid down arms for a chance at peace. These are not the fiends Lakshmi made them out to be. That bravery demands respect and deserves recognition. The House of Light is part of the city now, under the protection of Saint 14. In time, the memories of our past demons will fade, and our peoples will share laughter and stories. Our victory today will be one of them. More famous than Twilight Garb, I will make sure of it.
Look at the city. The skies are slowly clearing, but the streets are filled with dead Vex, dead Lakshmi, and our people. Future war cult has scattered to the wind, but we recovered Lakshmi's body from the site of the attack. In the end, she was right about the tragedy looming on our horizon. If only she could have foreseen that it was of her own making. Now Dead Orbit has finally made good on its promise to leave the city and take a new monarchy with it. The factions are no more. Honestly, I will miss their presence here. After all, Lakshmi did not speak for the future war cult. Some of her own people warned me she was becoming unstable, and I feel I let her slip away. I haven't told Saint yet, but I've been unable to locate Osiris. Even though Lakshmi implicated him in the attack, I don't believe he did. Osiris is a good man. Saint and I will both vouch for him. All he has to do is return to the city to clear his name. I saw the blight that was forming in our own citizens, but I never thought it would lead us here. Eris once said, "We will only know our enemy's next move if we are wise enough to recognize it." My eyes are wide open now. Stay ready.
People of the last city, I have some troubling news to share. As some of you know, a portal was opened in the Elixni quarter of the city, allowing Vex to breach our walls for the first time. Thankfully, Guardians, working together with Elixni Splicers, were able to repel the assault. We've since discovered that Lakshmi II, former leader of the future war cult, was responsible for the security breach. Regrettably, Lakshmi was killed by Vex during the assault. It seems that the other faction leaders were culpable, if not responsible. Executor Hideo and Arak Jalal have fled, taking the remainder of their factions with them. In their absence, we are now one people. Stronger, thanks to our alliance with the House Light.
House of Light is forever in your debt. You stood by us when we had no one. Now, we stand by the people of the last city. In the grace of the Traveler, come what may. The Light provides.
The Light provides.
With all that said, that is the end of the video, and thank you very much for watching. And of course, if you enjoyed the video, go ahead and leave a like and hit the subscribe button to keep up to date with Destiny content from my channel. You can also hit the bell next to subscribe to turn on those email notifications if you are so inclined. And of course, if you have your own thoughts and if you have any feedback on the audio quality, please let me know down below in the comments section. I'll be looking through that. To give you guys a little bit of a heads up as well, video content is going to be covering the Harpy, it's going to be talking about the future of the factions in the city, it's going to be talking a little bit more about a whole bunch of other stuff that has dropped and is sort of on the docket for things we need to cover. So, we'll be getting to that over the next few days, but in the meantime, thank you very much for watching, and know that as per usual, your viewership has been quite enough for me. And in the meantime, my name has been, my name is Bife. Parodasia Ad Astra. I'll see you, Starside.